Hi, welcome to a brand new episode of You Started It. My name is Daniel Fernandes, and on the podcast today, we have Shriya Pilgaonkar and Ashish Shakya. Shriya is an actor in film, theater, and the web, and Ashish has the best bachelor pad in Bandra.
This is true.
Welcome to the podcast, guys. I'm really excited to have you here. Finally.
Finally.
We won't say finally.
Times. Yeah, the thing with Shriya is, I, not many times. A couple of times I had to reschedule. Not entirely my fault.
One
and Ashish, you've been busy.
I had a thing yesterday.
So the headline that we're going to discuss today is from the Times of India. And this is the headline. Parents using social media to keep tabs on kids. This is not an episode from Black Mirror just yet, but I think we're getting there.
Yeah.
So this is a research basically that was done in America.
What I like about this is, first of all, the fact that we are discussing this. Because the headline's about like tweens and shit, and all of us are 30
Far
and something.
It. I'm
so
not
it's,
30 yet, speak for yourself.
Sorry, you will. You said you are 22. So... No, what I like about that is that ye hum relatable ke chakkar mein hum aa gaye hain. Bachcho bhai, we are attacking the latest market ki.
Tweens.
No, dekhenge.
We are giving the tweens a voice now.
Tweens ke issues.
Also, I have to Google
karenge.
The age group. Because I wasn't sure of this tweens ka age group. So it's 9 to 12, right?
Tweens,
or
I
14.
Think. No, and on the fact.
No, 14 is teens.
No, 6.
Yeah.
I read, but online.
What is a tween?
Trust.
A tween is an annoying child.
Tween is not really a teenager. It's like a pre-teen.
I thought a tween was a teenager
it's
on
a
Twitter.
Cuter teenager.
Basically, point is that
we have
an audience. This is one way to be like, kids, tumhare life mein kya issues hai? Tumhare parents tumhe track kare social media pe? Aao, hum baat karte hai iske baare mein.
Exactly. So, fans of Boombam, we are here for you. Yes, yeah, so basically what happened was then, and they did a research in America because in America research is legit,
of course.
As opposed to anywhere else.
Huh.
Ask Cambridge Analytica if you don't believe me. And so a lot of parents were, you know, majority of the parents said yes, that they use social media to keep a track on their kids, which is something that we are not used to. Of course,
we're
we grew up in a very different time.
Not at all used to this. Also, like the fact that somebody researched this, I think it is kind of obvious that a parent will do it right now, because parents have always done this. It's just that the tool has differed. Social media mein hum bach gaye because I think my parents, for example, are not on social media. They just don't give a fuck. So, and even if they were, like I said, like, kya bolega yaar? Matlab, we are beyond the age where you can track us. And what the fuck are you going to say? Like,
yeah.
Kya bolega humko?
Yeah, because like, when we grew up in the 90s, okay,
yeah.
Parental control in the 90s was three things. Permission, curfew and sleep.
Yeah.
Huh.
That was it,
huh.
You know. So you asked for permission if you could get out of the house. If you got the permission, you had to get back by a certain amount of time.
And whatever
when you came
yeah.
back,
you had to sleep.
To sleep.
And whatever you did outside, you didn't do this here, take my sex.
Exactly.
That was the best part. Like, and now when I look at how, like, some of my cousins are in this space, you know,
right.
Like how their parents can easily track them. Like, when we left the house, our parents had no idea if we were going to return.
But also, there was still, I mean, trust and comfort, and they knew we would return. Now, in spite of phones, I mean, no, not your parents.
I'm going to die.
I don't know if my son is going to come
back.
Agar wo nahi aaya to thoda khana extra reh jayega.
Ha, so are you saying?
No, I think just essentially, even though today we have our phones, I noticed that parents end up calling much more. They're equally unsure and fidgety and restless about it. And as compared to earlier, when phone nahi tha, but phir bhi ek calm energy thi,
huh.
You know.
Are your parents on social media?
Yeah, but not as much.
Like, do they like comment on your Facebook activity or Insta?
Not Facebook,
like,
yeah, but Insta, yes. Yeah,
yeah?
My mother
That's
does.
A scary place to have a parent.
Yeah, but
I mean, depends on what you post. Now. Because for me, my dad's not on social media at all. He's only on, he's happy with WhatsApp. Mom's on Facebook.
Yeah.
She doesn't know what Twitter is.
Yeah.
He doesn't know what Instagram is.
Yeah.
I'm happy. So my Facebook profile is very like parent friendly material.
Right.
Instagram is where I'm more honest. And Twitter is
where
I'm rabid.
Twitter
yeah.
is where your parents are insulted. So
yeah.
Your parents should not be on it.
On Twitter. Yeah. But then do you think the whole parent-child relationship has now become very complex because of social media? Has it become easier because of social media?
You know, as a long-time parent, I think what happens with social media is that it has generally led to a culture of over-information and anxiety, and
yeah.
I think that would probably seep into parenthood. Like, I can't imagine if I was 13 right now, right? I would be doing dumb shit
exactly.
on social media. I did dumb shit in life,
yeah.
Online nahi hai. And the fact that my parents could see it would make it impossible for them. Like, if I had a child and I saw them posting things, I would just be like, tu kya kar raha hai, tu pagal hai, ye galat hai, tu kya, like, what are you? Like, I don't know how parents retain their sanity and follow their kids' feet. Like, I would, it's weird.
It's really tough. And I was thinking about this the other day because I happened to see a child who was trying to zoom an actual flower. And the parent is saying, kitna cute hai mera bachcha, dekho kya kar raha hai.
In the real world.
Real world. Matlab aisa. That scared me.
That
scared me.
That's
it scared
funny,
me.
Dude.
And also, I mean, today, instead of actual toys, you know, being the child has screens. So, tactile, matlab sab ye tuk tuk tuk.
Dude, bachcha chod, mere saath hota hai. Main Kindle pe itna padha hai. That main kabhi bhi book padhta hai, toh main, I click on the word in the book to find the meaning and then...
Exactly. That is so scary.
Yeah, but these parents also put these devices in their kids' hands, right?
But is it scary? Like, what is... Because I'm wondering how much of it is actually scientifically backed and how much of it is just afraid of a new thing. Like, when we were kids, our parents were wary of, like, us sitting in front of the TV for too long.
Right.
Before that, their parents must have been worried about, I don't know, like... films and like
radio.
I don't know, like, it's just a thing that kids are born with. It's just technology, how much of it is scary.
I think the worry essentially is, just as you said, the overload of information, and at what age can you handle what information, honestly. And I think this information can come even if you don't own a gadget. You have your friends who own it, so there's no control.
Right.
So I think the only thing that parents can do, or I feel like in good parenting that I've observed, is that they have very good and open communication with their children.
Right.
They don't make them feel guilty or they don't make them feel like, kya dekh raha hai? Dekha? Kya na? You know? Because they'll find a way that kabhi na kabhi wo incognito window kya hai pata chal jayega. History erase kaise karni hai wo pata chal jayega.
I think one of the best things about us growing up without so much technology is that we could keep secrets from our parents.
Yes.
Yeah.
And in general, when we were idiots, it was limited to our, like, people who were in physical proximity.
Haan, jisne dekha,
haan.
Dekha,
haan,
bas.
Correct.
But you still have control. What do you mean secrets? I mean, it's in your hand whether you want to post about a secret or not.
But now it's tough, na? Because see, the thing is, right now you have to, and we also do this, yaar. Every time you go somewhere, you have to check in, you have to take a selfie, you have to show that you're Friday night.
You don't have
night.
To do it, Danny. You don't have
still
to do it.
Do it. I don't understand the need. People should know I'm at Google Cloud. These people are like Bane, they have been born into the social media ecosystem.
Exactly. We figure it out. You know, they are born into it. Like, for us, now we have to show that our Friday night is lit or our Sunday is relaxed and stuff. Like, for them, like, fucking every single day, school, mein, like, aaj geometry class, mein kya mast sikha mein.
Like, I don't know. You know, aur tab jab chutiya katta tha na, to aisa limited. Let's say, I'm trying to think, okay, so once, in 8th standard or something, I want to ask this girl out and the whole, like, class knew about that shit, and then very publicly, I'm coming back from like a library period or something, very publicly, she walks up to me in the lunch break, everyone's staring.
Oh, wow.
She grabs my hand and I'm like, wow, ladki ne haath pakda, amazing.
Hawa chal rahi thi?
Nahi, hawa chal rahi, music, violin, sab, Shahrukh Khan bhi aage sab. Aur phir haath mein rakhi, because us din raksha bandhan tha. So, ye puri class ke saamne hua. But that was fine, because it was limited to that, aur phir log bhool gaye. लेकिन अगर वो सोशल मीडिया के दिन होता वो तो लाइव स्ट्रीम होता
लाइक 10 कैमरास
फिर मैं ऐसा इमो पोएम लिखता जिसमें हाफ लेटर कैपिटल हाफ लेटर स्मॉल फिर वो ऐसा लिखती फिर उसका फ्रेंड उसको लाइक करती फिर डिसलाइक लाइक आई कांट इमेजिन डूइंग दैट एंड देन कम्युनिकेटिंग via Snapchat and stuff like that. It's
I would have watched
bizarre.
This Facebook Live, but
it
I would have been
yeah. in hindsight.
Because a lot of your fond memories as a child is embarrassing stories of someone else.
Huh. Correct.
You know,
I'm not even kidding. Ninth standard, my dude shat his pants. Amazing. Amazing. It was very funny. Usko 2 saal tak usko tatti master bulate the log. So, now imagine, agar ye social media ke time hota, to bechara uska kya halat hota? Poor guy.
Kya hota? Kya
dude, embarrassing. Dude. So,
see, tatti master look, like this versus tatti master on a Facebook wall and a Snapchat streak and whatever. I don't know, man. It's a...
I remember... Rohan a couple of weeks back or 3 weeks back he shared a screenshot of somebody who said something really stupid to him on he said kill yourself or something go kill yourself and all that so everybody reported him and I also retweeted that image of this guy who was being a dick to Rohan basically for no reason at all. This guy's friends have messaged me on Instagram saying bhai tum log kya kar rahe ho is college mein sab uski le rahe hain abhi and I'm just like dude you started you tried to be a hero initially I think it was this whole thing, like, may Rohan Joshi ko kya bolega, may kya bolega. And it all turned against him. And apparently now he's the victim.
But you can imagine if this happens, I mean, in our age group, tweens would be so much more, I mean, there's much more vulnerability there, right?
Yeah, like, I would imagine if you put up a photo, if we put up photos, people say, shit, it's fine, fucking, I don't care. But if you're a kid and, like, you have people commenting on how you look and what you're wearing and all that, I imagine it must fuck with your head a little
bit. It does. It does.
What scary is my cousin. I mean, recently I added her on Instagram and I'm looking at these amazing pictures. And otherwise, she's not, I mean, she doesn't talk much and, you know, she's in her own thing. And I was reading the conversations like a creep. I'm being that sister who's, like, reading her conversations. And the way she's talking, I'm like, no, she's growing up and stuff like AF. You know, you look hot AF. Like, don't talk like that.
Dude, I saw that with another cousin. Like, this used to be a little girl, mein usko baith ke sa maths homework karaya, like 12 years ago, and now she's like a boyfriend and shit, and like all her photos are just top angle selfies. So it's very cute, but I'm like,
have you noticed, but the way people talk online is it's completely different, but it's generic. I mean, you know, just the way teenagers or tweens, or I guess even all of us, there's a certain
internet lingo, na? Kuch but ek. For us, that was MSN Messenger. Huh. You remember MSN Messenger? Yeah. Like, yeah. We started for us. Like, remember, I don't know. You're talking about embarrassing situations. How many of you, I'm talking about the audience, but you remember when Yahoo chat was a thing?
Yes.
And that time you were not connected to any of your friends. You would go into chat rooms.
I remember chat rooms.
And this was not even from the convenience of your home or from your phone. You had to go to a cyber cafe. Cyber cafes were a thing there. And it was the shadiest setup ever, because you would have these booths where you would have these computers and then there are curtains.
And a lot of jizz inside the booth.
Always. Someone or the other jerking off in one of the other booths. And
देखो इंडियंस अडैप्ट कर जाते
हैं
सो इसी जगह में
सो दैट्स सो फॉर अस आवर चैट लिंगो बैक इन द डे वाज ASL
करेक्ट या ऑफ कोर्स
व्हिच फॉर द लॉन्गेस्ट टाइम आई थॉट मेंट एसोल सो पीपल लाइक तू गाली क्यों दे रहा है
यस यू आर राइट आई फॉरगॉट
या सो यू लाइक एंड देन पीपल विल रिप्लाई विद लाइक व्हाटएवर 18 मेल और फीमेल
16F कैली एंड आई एम लाइक
नो एंड कैली या कैली
16F कैली
कैली वाज द
डिपेंड ऑन व्हेन यू लॉग्ड ऑन राइट सो इट वाज लेट एट नाइट तो अमेरिका में सुबह तो बोलो
हां
Yeah, and it was mind-blowing though. That was the first time like we realized, oh wow, I can talk to the world at large. Like I'm talking to this girl in Australia and some girl speaking Spanish. And then I'm having cyber sex with somebody who's probably a man in hindsight. I think we've discussed this before on one more podcast, but essentially every dude in India has had cyber sex with each other. Like, I think we've had cyber sex. So pata bhi nahi hoga ki main tha tu tha. Yeah.
Doesn't matter who's at the other end.
Tunnel buddies of a different kind.
So, abhi lekin I'm glad that our parents could monitor all of that, because it wasn't like public and whatever, the social aspect wasn't there. I think people are worried about the kids. I'm also a little worried about the parents. Unka sar phat raha hoga na, like,
it must be tough. That's exactly what I'm saying. It's like, one of the reasons why I'm not so keen on having kids is because who's going to keep track of these people?
This is your only reason.
No, many reasons. I'll tell you later over dinner, but I'm just saying it's tough, dude. I have cats, okay? And I have stress. Like, have they been fed on time? You know, do they have enough water? Now, imagine if my cats had mobile phones and they had their own Instagram account and they were like fucking chatting with other cats.
With all the other cats and saying, my owner doesn't understand me, fuck him and all that.
Yeah. Exactly. And what if that cat was chatting with another cat but it was actually a dog? You know?
Yeah.
Good point.
You worry about these things. You know, you want your cat to only like, I mean, I don't
talk
mind.
To you?
No, I don't mind if my cats interact with other species, equality and all of that stuff. But you know what I'm saying, right? You don't want your cat to get into bad company and stuff like that.
Yeah, because as a parent, you're paranoid to begin with.
Exactly.
Even without technology on it is hardwired.
Yeah.
It's like, I made this.
Parents to be.
This is from my
parent. Dude, it's the weirdest thing. Like, barish hoga na Bombay mein. It's a little bit barish. My mother will call. Kahan ho? Because she remembers July 2005. Yeah. So, I'm sitting in a comfortable room. It's all dry. Samas ghar mein baitha hai. Itna ba... Nahin, yaar, traffic ruk jaye. Arre, kuch nahin, yaar. Rajneesh, I think, used to have this set about same observation about like, I think Afghanistan mein earthquake was uske maar
Delhi
mein ho kya earthquake Afghanistan mein bhi like,
but this happens to all of us, right?
Even though
we are not twins, like, I get this a lot, especially because I live away from my parents. So my mom will call, I call my parents and they'll call me like a couple of days ago I wasn't well. My mom would call, have you eaten, you know, and you know, I've been taking your medicine. And for 2 days I was out of action. So it was yesterday actually, I rested the whole day, just medicated myself, and I literally did nothing. So my mom is so cute, she called me, she's like, okay, so have you, you know, eaten food, what did you eat? And then so I said, okay, I ate so and so thing. Did you make it or did you order it? She said, I ordered it. Okay, have you taken a medicine? I'm like, yeah, I've taken a medicine. Okay, and what else?
What's up? It became that conversation.
Yeah. What else has been up? I'm like, I'm not well. There's nothing.
Not
much.
Well. They're trying to bond. That is happening.
And it's very cute, you know. But with our parents, it's more of a like, okay, I'm just making sure you're still alive.
Do you know what my mom does? Sometimes she texts me on Insta DM. She says hi. I say hi. She's like, why are you online? I said, you messaged me. She said, I was just checking if you're online or not.
You don't get it, right? Like, pehle you had to be online to receive a message. Now you can receive a message
anytime.
Are you online?
That's so funny.
I just wanted to make sure that, you know, you don't have your phone
with
you.
This is like your mom basically prank calling you. Doing, aapke ghar nal se paani aa raha hai kya? Like, your mom is calling.
Because I think now parents have less control over kids than they used to. Like back in the day, dude, if we did something wrong, our parents would say no TV and that's it. Our lives were ruined. Go to your room and no TV. You had nothing to do. Now what are you going to do? Go to your room. You still have your phone. You still have the internet.
Some parents are much more strict. They do sort of confiscate. I'm saying the younger lot. They take their phones away. They just have like a certain time of the day when they can get access to their phone. But still, you can't be next to your child. I mean, that's never going to happen. So essentially, I guess, parents try to just equip them with a certain understanding on how to make better choices.
I don't know how you set boundaries for that sort of thing, because I'm pretty much attached to my phone.
Yeah.
So I have no standing when I tell a child, hey, phone pe mat ghuse rahe.
But it's not just about, you know, being addicted to your phone. It's also for them at that level, what information, what are they perceiving out of this, who they're meeting, who they're talking to. That worry is that judgment that the child is making.
Which is fair. Like, actually, there's one thing I control, because, and young people will not get this, but the internet is full of creeps.
Absolutely.
It's a dangerous place. And like, I would like to restrict that access, and kids will not understand at that level.
And to not take it as seriously also.
Yeah, like, just...
There was this message going around, this forward on WhatsApp. I don't know how much of it was true, but I think it is because... it's about, you know, be careful about the pictures your kids are uploading, because these pictures are geotagged. So apparently, if you save the picture and if it's a geotag pic, pedophiles can, you know, figure out where you live and stuff like that. It is very scary. Yeah. So I can imagine why parents are freaked out, but at the same time, kids also want to fit in. Yeah. Like,
some parents actually have their philosophy of not sharing their kids' pictures online. They're very clear about it.
From day
one. Because what happens is, as a parent, if you share a kid's photos, you don't have the kid's consent. A.
Number
and
one.
B. The thought is, the theory is that you are exposing them to a lot more risk.
Exactly.
Just by putting up their photos. So I don't know how they deal with that. And once the kid is old enough to have his own cell phone and go to parties and make plans, and you see it all publicly, and the second an Indian parent sees party, uske dimag mein to matlab orgy chal raha hai, like kya ho raha hai,
cocaine, narcos. Well, that is a very interesting point, because right now, like, people our age, okay, who are having kids are actually documenting every single day of that experience. Yeah. Even before the baby is born, they're taking photos. They're doing pre-baby photo shoots, and the baby is born, ye mera bachcha hai. And like what you said is right, they have no consent. Those kids who have just been born, like in the last couple of years, when they grow up, imagine the digital baggage they're going to have. That's insane.
Maine bhi dale hai bachcho ke photo mere.
Another reason why I'm not very keen.
Two reasons.
That's cool. But as a kid, if you're being tracked, it must get super annoying, because you make plans on a wall or a Facebook and a mother's like, kya likha tha wo? Ye litaf kya hota hai?
Litaf
kya hota hai? Aur ye jo wo bangan wala, ye kya hota hai? Bangan wala symbol kya hota hai? Ye kya hota hai? Aur ye pani mani aaya, mujhe pata sab ye symbol kya hai?
Ye FML kya hai? FML kya hai?
Ye jeep kyun nikal rahi hai? Ye kisi face kisko ja rahe hain? Tum padhai kar rahe ho ki kya kar rahe ho? Like, it would just be so annoying for that shit to be public. But you know what? As kids, they will find a way around. Parents ko pata bhi nahi chala. It's just complicated. Yeah. Kids are trying to do the max shit they can, and parents are like, "Ye kya kar raha
hai?" Yeah, that's the whole game, right? It's the whole cat and mouse thing that you can keep an eye on me as much as you want, but I'm still gonna do what I want to do. Yeah. You know.
I know someone whose child had Googled kisses in Bollywood.
Nice.
Simple kisses in Bollywood.
Nice.
And so the father sort of he saw that, and you know. I'm sure like the both of them, the mom and the dad, had like a serious discussion. How do we deal with this now? You know, the child has Googled kisses in Bollywood. But they just casually went to the child saying, just started talking about, you know, ki what is a good kiss. When mommy, daddy kiss you,
correct.
It's different.
Correct.
Anyone else kissing you is different. When you become an adult, aap bade ho jaoge, to when you kiss someone is different. But wo bada wala kissing baad mein, abhi nahin.
Haan.
So besides,
complicated,
without acknowledging that kisses in Bollywood thing. So they were not trying to, they didn't say ki aapne wo kyun dekha, kya tha.
But they accept, addressed which to is the great, issue. Which is great. The only sad thing about is that wo bache ne, bechare ne, itne ghatiya kisses dekhe honge na, search ke baad. Kisses in Bollywood mein itna kachra dekha hoga na. Aisa Aamir Khan aur Karishma Kapoor ka chal raha hai Raja Hindustani mein.
Before he got to that, he'll just see pictures of flowers. And he's like, why are we seeing flowers?
Yeah. And like a lot of Imran Hashmi is happening. Like, yeah. I'm just saying, like, he will learn how to kiss like this. Like, he's not going to learn really properly. It's a bad, this thing.
Don't want that visual.
He sees in bot. But kids also, that's a funny thing. Kids don't know what to search for, right?
Yeah.
Like when I was young. Like if you wanted to, like the first time you got the internet, you want to search for nude pictures, you don't know. So you just went like,
dude, sex, and that too, dot com, nude like. Pictures on dial-up.
Oh, what?
Dial-up as in?
Dial-up internet connection. Huh? So you...
Like, what's a dial-up?
No. What is this?
I know what
generation gap you have created.
I know what you mean. I know what you mean. But it took a minute for me to...
Like the dial-up.
Dial-up.
No, because back in the day as kids, you know, how like right now today, these kids will just take a phone, type whatever they want to and it's instant access. Okay,
yeah.
When we had to do it, it was always a group activity because not everyone didn't have the internet. It was one guy.
It takes forever to...
And
connect.
It would take forever to load, and there was this blue color line that would keep filling up, you know, to load the progress of the page. The photo will not even load in one shot. It'll just be bit by bit. And just when it's getting interesting, the phone would ring.
Correct.
So, like, do you think like parents now have to be more proactive and talk to their kids about stuff like this? Like,
I think they just need to make sure that their kids are comfortable in expressing themselves and they're not afraid, because the minute there's fear involved and the kids are not going to perhaps, you know, share anything and they'll feel the need to hide. So I don't think necessarily the kids have to share everything, but at least as parents, I think they shouldn't be, matlab, utna bhi aise, you know, intrusive nahi hona chahiye.
Itna much hai yaar, bachcha.
I know, right? Just think about, like,
emotional health, spiritual health,
mental health, all of
watch
that.
Watch them, but don't watch them too much.
Yeah.
But if you let them go, they'll do this. But let them make some mistakes, so mistakes
that's
are important.
That's just that much you can protect, yeah.
Shit, yeah. So tough, dude.
And now then people ask, so why aren't you having kids? Cause fucking, it's
which is why I think we can sum this up by saying that the best approach to this is to just adopt pets, you know.
It's good. That's good. I like approach. How this podcast has turned into population control abhiyan.
Yeah, exactly.
It's slightly related, but इसमें ना अगेन ट्रैक करने में टेक्नोलॉजी का जरूरत नहीं, बिकॉज़ वन माय फेवरेट स्टोरीज टू एवर कम आउट ऑफ इंडिया इज दैट हर साल नवरात्रि के टाइम इट्स अ फैक्ट दैट द नंबर ऑफ प्राइवेट डिटेक्टिव्स हायर्ड
करेक्ट
बॉम्बे आल्सो एंड आई थिंक गुजरात फॉर श्योर. And there have been every year like this.
And there's a correlation to condom sales also.
Condom sales also. Same reason.
And
same reason.
Article comes every year.
So, wo garba.
Every year.
Which is hilarious to me ki har saal aisa ek Gujarati aadmi jata hai private detective ke paas. Mere bache pe nazar rakho. Because that's what you want. Like a strange man tailing your child. And this guy will go and he'll follow some
16. Not just bacha, partners bhi na.
Partners, whatever. He'll go and follow some 16-year-old. Literally chane ke khet mein jayega. Wo like, bahut hi extreme nahi ho gaya. प्राइवेट डिटेक्टिव अपने बच्चे पे डालना है, मतलब शर्लॉक को और कुछ काम नहीं है, तुम्हारा गरबा रास देखने जाएगा, लाइक क्या चल रहा है यार.
आई फाउंड इट डैम फनी डू.
या
And I was, so have you ever
it's
been?
It's fascinating though. Huh, what?
Have you ever been to one of these like Navratri?
I was 14 years old. I was dancing. There was this cute girl and I did like this. Uske haath pe lag gayi. Aur uske baad maine dance nahi
kiya. Same thing happened to me.
Like, I love you.
It's confusing. Uske haath pe lag
because
it's such a dirty face.
It's a technique. Yeah, even I didn't know and I ended up hitting the girl on the hand and she made this face and I was like, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
It just walked out. And then there's an investigator taking photos like, okay, this boy is not a threat. He's hitting on the hand.
He will be rejected.
He will be rejected. Yeah, but, and so it would be amazing being that kid and then you notice a guy following you like a really
but
bad
they do
spy.
This investigating thing even now and then looking for arranged marriages, this right? Groom and stuff.
This is true.
It's scary.
Which brings us back to shaadi bhi mat karo, guys.
Take shaadi mat karo.
They check their Facebook profiles also. In fact, don't even like companies also do that, right? They go through their social media. They check what you've been saying, what you haven't. So it's not just parents, I think. But everyone's, I think, online persona sometimes is really different from how you as a person. Like, have you met someone and you've been like, "Arey, online vibe tera bahut hi alag hai," and in person tu bahut alag hai.
Haan, ye true hai. Main bahut tweet ups pe gaya hoon. Toh ye humne notice kiya hai ki online kuch log hote hai. Wow, fuck yeah. And then go online. Okay.
Yeah. This manufactured image.
I'm sure people say the same thing about us too.
Yeah. Achha, so we'll sum this up by saying, don't have kids. Don't be a parent. Don't get married.
Detectives mat bhejo.
And
what is the last thing?
Shaadi bhi mat karo. Have pets. Adopt pets.
Adopt pets. Cats are best. Dogs are best.
Main to uske liye bhi aalsi hu, but sure.
Grow old by yourself and die alone.
Happy basically to do that. Very good at it.
Have a great Sunday, guys.
Okay, this is what happens when you add a bunch of 33-year-olds sitting and talking about life.
मैं 33 नहीं हूँ.
अच्छा यार तू ठीक तू Bollywood से 22 है. मैं 30
पहुँची भी नहीं हूँ.
You must have like a Bollywood age and a real age.
Actually, I don't know. I'm 28 and I'm proud to be 28.
Your new generation.
I like to say that. मतलब मैं.
Yeah, I'm 27. Proud to be 27.
Will your age? Will you auto deduct your age after a certain age?
No. See, I look young. My screen age is lesser, ना. तो इसलिए problem नहीं है.
Show off. मगर तो त्वचा से मेरी उम्र का पता ही नहीं चलता.
All right.
Good.
So we'll move to the next part of the podcast, which is the Q&A, where fans of you both have sent in questions.
I'm a little wary about this. Public kuch bhi poochta
hai. Haan, kuch bhi poochta hai public. So first question is for you, Ashish. This question is from Swati. And she says that I find that it is not a part of being an Indian public figure to take a political stand.
Okay.
As is in the case in the States. And just, I especially find that comedians often refrain in stating their political inclinations. They stand mostly on the fringe. Why is that?
Actually, that's not entirely true. Because if you've, been tracking the comedy scene since the last 7 odd years since it's come up, you will remember that a lot of comics came up punching up at the Congress government and later even the BJP government. A lot of comics, including us at AIB, then later, I mean, the most prominent faces now, I think, would be Kamra. And a lot of other people, if you just go to the open mic circuit, you'll see a lot of comics doing it. If you mean in terms of there is no out there biting satire, John Oliver types, again, we tried something in On Air, but if you're looking at an established culture, it's the simple answer would be we just don't have that. Because in the US, you've had 60, 70 years of anti-establishmentarianism where you have people from like right from Larry Flynt to like the comedians later, everybody has challenged that and they've come out winning. They have such strong free speech laws here. I think after a point, I can speak for myself and I can speak for some other comics as well. I know the choice literally comes down to to bhai ye joke banna hai ki tumhe tumhara office chalana hai. So it tumhe joke manna hai ki tumhare office mein patthar pad aur 2 hafta band ho jao, logo ko salary nahi mile. Like a lot of that comes into play with taking on certain certain political figures in the establishment in general, and I think it's a process of learning. I think it's a continuous process.
We're not there yet. Like, even bigger stars like the Sachin Tendulkars and the Amitabh Bachchan and stuff like that, who have so much of influence, they will never comment on something, you know.
But that's also a choice because you know what you're going to get.
The backlash.
The backlash is... Like, sometimes, I mean, that itself is so much to deal with that you feel like, I'm 75 years old. Do I really want to do that? You know, I want to be at peace.
And I used to be younger and angry, and I used to be like, fucking the star should speak up about issues and things like that. Now I'm a little soft on that because I understand, as sad as it is, I understand, having seen the workings, you know literally how one tweet or taking a certain stand can result in literally 200 crores worth of money, thousands of people's jobs on the line getting lost. So the trade-off at that point seems dumb. It's a no-brainer.
And a lot is lost in context as well.
And the thing is now, the blame falls on stars, the blame falls on people who don't speak up, but that's when the real conversation gets sidelined, which is that in India, you don't have laws that protect free speech. Defamation is the easiest one that you'll get slapped with. Defamation is a criminal offense in India. Hmm. Other places, it's a civil offense. Criminal matlab, if you get convicted, you go to jail. Civil matlab, khali fine lega, jail nahi jayega. Hamare time pe, we tried, there are people who tried approaching the courts to try and turn it into a civil offense. Not going to happen because it is the number one tool used by politicians or anyone who wants to be protected from being called out. So if a company is called out for malpractice, the first thing that they'll slap on a journalist is a 300 crore defamation. Comedians, the same thing. So I think we have none of that. We don't have exceptions in terms of religious jokes. We have no protection. So a lot of people beyond a point, I also think of this, like when I look at the US and you look at some of the satire they've created, some of the stuff that Oliver and Colbert and Stewart and all these people, the things they say and do, you just can't do that here because they are protected by law. They are protected by years and years of conversation that has not happened in our country.
Correct.
One example, this is a name we don't like to use very often. So, I'll not use the comic's name. But in the run-up to the US elections, when Donald Trump was gaining popularity, very popular comic at the time in the US, in a column he wrote, called him a cunt. And there was nobody at his house the next day. There was no pathar, there was no FIR, there was no aag laga denge, there was no media cycle being spun around it, because that's the kind of thing it is. People must have protested, written, whatever.
We are far from that.
So we're not in that space. Yeah. So that's a constraint I also see. I hope we all work together to create a society where the free speech laws offer us that. And every comic will tell you this, dude. The day we get strong free speech law, the day you can say things,
everyone will go without consequence. All guns
Republic, matlab hum log kya wo India gate pe khade hoke hum comedy show karenge sabke bare mein. Lekin beyond the point, I get that our satire is not the strongest it can be.
But you do find a way to express what you
You do. Between a lot of the content we've created, between a lot of the content that other comics are creating, and I find some of them to be incredibly brave. There is a way, but there will always be that benchmark, international benchmark, which I think we're going to just keep shy of hitting, just because.
Yeah, I think if the fans want the benchmark, or the general public want a benchmark where, you know, we can say the kind of things that is said in the US, I think we also need a benchmark in terms of the way they receive or they respond to the kind of things we say. Fair enough. Okay, cool. Next question is for you, Shriya. It's from Vinayak. It says, what kind of cinema did you grow up watching? And what do you watch on Netflix now?
What do I... Oh my God. I just started watching Wild
Country.
Yes, Wild Country. I just started watching that. I binge watch. I'm so scared to watch things, like start watching something, because the whole day is then just gone. Main aise ek episode aaj kal nahi dekh sakti. But I watch all kinds of things. I grew up watching a lot of animation. Animation is something that I love.
Okay.
And ye world cinema and all bahut baad mein aaya, but I liked dad had introduced me to a lot of good films, whether it's like your Pyasa se leke to, you know, Andaz Apna Apna, what we grew up watching.
Right.
So I watched a lot of stuff, and regional language films also, so Marathi films ho, Hindi ho, English ho. So that was never one thing, but I remember animation as being something that was like my go-to. I enjoyed that a lot. And like, it's a dream for me to be, give my voice to, and
What kind of character?
I don't know.
Is there an animated character that you look at and wish like, oh, I would voice that?
I don't know. I love Finding Nemo. So maybe like, I don't
know. So would you, which, whose voice? Would it be Dory?
Ellen. I can't remember.
Dory, right?
Yeah. No, but no, I don't want to be one of them, but I don't know. Maybe something original. Nothing existing. Like that.
There was
all
an animated film that Bollywood made, right? Where Saif was a cat or something.
No, dog.
Roadside Romeo.
Roadside Romeo. Was that a nice movie?
I have not seen it.
I think I saw it. It was. I think it was Bollywood's
Wire
first.
Yeah. I think Yashraj.
Attempt at an animated film. Yeah.
I haven't watched it yet. But we have scope. A lot of, I mean, when I see these animated films, credits mein main dekhti hu, bahut aise Indians ke naam hote hain. Par humare yahan pe ab tak utna paisa nahi laga hai. We have apna wo Hanuman ki kaun si film thi wo? Hanuman? Baby Hanuman ki abhi koi aayi thi, animation thi.
No.
Yeah. I forget what it's called.
Wrong target audience.
You don't like animation?
No, I like
animation.
Kids will watch a lot of this.
I know there's a lot of animation on TV, but as far as films are concerned, Indian animated films, that's the only one
I remember.
Roadside Romeo. Cool. Animated films and Wild Wild Country.
Wild Wild
Country
is crazy.
I love, by the way, Marvelous Mrs. Maisel.
Oh, fuck, what a good show.
So
I
good.
Love that show.
So good.
So good. Sharp.
That's something that I was really inspired by. Such good performances. And you just feel like, I mean, we want this content. We want to get to be a part of it. You know,
and
I wish we could just create that.
And it looks beautiful, the show. The ensemble is great. Writing sharp. It just looks so colorful and so different from everything else on TV.
Absolutely.
So, I was discussing with friends. Everything else on TV is now in that broody mood. Unrealistic, grim. And Maisel is like one splash of color. It's lovely.
Have you watched it?
No.
I will check it out.
You'll love it.
Put it on the list.
It's funny whenever you know you ask someone, have you seen this show? They go, ah, abhi tum log discuss kar rahe ho. Maine to last year dekha tha.
Yeah, that competition. I've seen it before you.
Yeah. Mere sab ego bilkul
nahi. Tu abhi.
There are few people like that. We're like, abhi.
Not us. We are too cool for that. Okay, Shaq, next one is for you. This is from Saket.
Okay.
Saket. Do comedians feel that they have a moral obligation to take over the role of unbiased journalism? Since kids nowadays get news from comedy sketches or podcasts rather than traditional heavily biased news organizations.
Good question.
Okay. Hell no. First of all, if you're getting your news from comedians, then change your source. Comedians are not journalists. And if you think comedians are unbiased, I don't think that's entirely true. Every comedian comes into a certain bias. I think it's just that most of our biases tend to be in the same place, so we agree. And by and large, comedians tend to be anti-establishment, which is fine. But please do not get your news source just from comedians. If you think your obvious news sources are biased, please look for unbiased sources. Please look for clearer writing. Question everything that you know. And comedians, I guarantee you, are under no moral obligation to present the news. And it's dangerous because comedians are looking at the very core of it to entertain you. So you might find oversimplification in certain aspects. You might find sometimes they're just wrong because they went for a punchline instead of a fact. And it can happen. And also, I'm very wary of taking on that role, even though that's something we've been sort of associated with.
Yeah.
Both as AIB and individually as well, simply because it's a question of, I think, interest, in the sense that a comedian has no obligation to talk about issues, talk about news, if he's not that kind of person in real life. Because then it's just faking it. And that's bullshit. Like, sometimes, and I talk about this on stage now, sometimes I just want to talk about dumb shit, man. I'm not a very smart person. Sometimes, like that day, I went up on stage and I talked about farts and like porn and just dumb shit. And I made it interesting.
Yeah.
But comedians, they're don't tie them down to you are a comedian. You
must don't put that kind of pressure. Yeah.
Because comedians will take on that role themselves. There are people who are politically inclined who will do that kind of comedy. And there are people who will talk about, I don't know, like potatoes. Whatever.
Yeah.
Their job is to entertain.
Dude, I like a bunch of us also get messages from kids who tell us that they use our material in their answers in exams and stuff, which I find, I'm like, what are you not, like, what is happening in
but
your
school?
But they
do understand that's a very subjective opinion.
Exactly
that
what I'm like.
It depends though, like if they're using information that they got from us, like essentially the setup, that's great.
Yeah.
You know, which is fine.
So they've quoted my jokes in some paper. I was like,
that's,
That's
yeah,
creative.
That's
yeah.
a bit. I don't know.
I'm like, what are your yeah. teachers doing?
Yeah. They're like, who are you watching?
Funny. Like on air, we were very sure that we had to, our research had to be super solid. So even season one and season two, season one was the largest team ever assembled.
Correct.
Research team for a show like this. Even season two was super tight, super rigorous research team, because you have to, like, if you have to take that responsibility, man, if you're doing news comedy. But that kind of comedy requires resources and it requires certain bent of mind. Not all comics will lean towards that. So let them,
I think it's
be.
Fair. Let every comic let do whatever be. Brand of comedy they want to do.
Yeah.
And without pressure, I think.
Without
you
pressure.
Know, if some comics, they don't feel like talking about bringing like politics or religion or whatever, then fair enough. I feel like there should be no pressure.
Yeah, like exactly.
People do put a lot of pressure though, I feel
correct.
Like.
Yeah. Like on stage, you're talking about a lot of personal stuff, right?
Yeah, exactly. I'm not talking about the news at all.
Yeah. Same, maybe apna therapy karke hato stage. The guys, very left me, chal raha hai, suno.
Help
me.
Existentialism
and
all, yeah. So yeah, the point is, let comedians talk about whatever they want to talk about. If you want reliable sources of news, watch Republic TV. All right, Shriya, next question is for you. Okay, this is from Shreyas, and he says, your parents are absolute legends in Marathi cinema and Bollywood, and now you have joined that fraternity.
Yeah.
Are you still under the pressure to fill in their shoes? And if there is any pressure, how do you handle this pressure?
I don't think I've been brought up in a way to, I guess, not feel that pressure.
Hmm.
And I think I've always done things a little differently, and I've been sort of told that whatever you do, you just have to be the best at it. So I've never felt the pressure. But yes, as an individual, I feel like whatever it is I do, I have to be the best at it. So that doesn't come, that just comes from being the person. Why is he laughing?
Yes, I'm taking a Tutu Mama reboot. Please, everyone wants to know. Nation wants to know.
Tutu Mama ka aaya tha, you know, actually, wo, it was called Kadvi Khatti Meethi. Ek
really?
Second part aaya tha.
Achha?
Can I tell you fun fact?
Yeah.
It's a bahut hi bada fun fact. Hai, jo, I think my dad doesn't talk about it, but main aaj kehna chahungi. Ki, there was a title that was registered for the second season, I think, of Tutu Meme.
Huh.
And dad once got a call from Jitendra ji saying ki Ekta ko ek title achha laga hai, wo unhe chahiye, can she have it?
Hmm.
So dad was like, theek hai, rakh sakte hain. Kyunki Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi was my dad's title.
Oh.
And for the longest time, I mean he was like, he got a special thanks for that.
Yeah.
So, it's interesting how another show like that was made. It was completely different.
Very different.
But yeah, when you look at it in the Tutu Meme context, yeah.
Usme intentional jokes come the.
Yeah. No, but I don't feel that pressure. But of course, I think you just want to really be good at your craft.
Correct.
That is the most important thing. Because every actor's journey is going to be different. You can't compare. And ye launch alag baat hai. You can probably begin on a certain note. But where you go is entirely up to you. And it's a lot of people ask me this question, or any celebrity child, that, you know, it's so easy for you all. What? Aise nahi hota hai. Itna easy nahi hota.
Thoda easy
matlab kya easy hai bolte hai? No one messes with you in that sense.
Oh.
Aapko wo izzat milti hai. And aapko, I think, people take you seriously. And it also depends how you present yourself. But if you're not good at your craft, toh doesn't matter ki aapke parents kaun hai. You know, and if you're happy, I mean, wo examples humne dekhe hain yaar. So,
I mean, humne examples ye bhi dekhe ki wo successful ho gaye, unko leeway bahut milta hai.
Yeah.
But I don't know if that's still a, I don't know if that's still a thing. Like a lot of the examples we cite are from like 10, 15 years
ago. Right,
I don't know if that's still
But fair enough. I'm saying, why be apologetic about it?
No.
Sometimes you are made to feel apologetic about it. I feel like you should, I mean, so my first film, actually, my Marathi film, Ekulti Ek, my dad had directed it. Hmm. And he had watched me perform on stage and he's like, keep, you know, I didn't know ki tu act bhi kar leti hai. Would you like to, it's a father-daughter script and, you know, I'd like to make it with you.
Right.
I said, let me read the script and, you know, if I feel, hum log karenge. And, you know, we did it.
Hmm.
And ये मेरे दिमाग में हमेशा आया था कि सो प्रेडिक्टेबल द फर्स्ट फिल्म यू आर डूइंग यू नो पापा के साथ लोग क्या बोलेंगे एंड माय मॉम टोल्ड मी वेरी समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग शी सेड दिस इज यू ब्रिंगिंग योर ईगो इनटू इट कि लोग क्या कहेंगे और मुझे अपने दम पे करना ठीक है पर अपॉर्चुनिटी मिली है ना मिली है अपॉर्चुनिटी ओन इट एंड बी अमेजिंग एट इट You know, show the world that this is an opportunity well deserved. If you're bad, you're bad. So I decided not to think about it like that. And eventually, jo mere struggles hue hain aur jo hain, wo mere apne hain.
Fair. Like, you know? I think the anger to nahi bol sakta, but the A lot of people were annoyed earlier when that whole debate broke out about nepotism, because a lot of people were just, I think, not accepting the fact that there is a benefit.
Yeah.
And a lot of people were like,
of course there is a benefit. Of course there is a benefit.
Okay, they were not cognizant of their privilege.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, which some actors now are, yeah, which is
yeah,
great.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, who's going to give up an opportunity, obviously. Right.
But what's important is if you're just going to be happy with the opportunity and then, you know, become complacent and not push it or take it further to yeah. make your own mark, then you can clearly tell. Then it's up to you. So, I mean, for me, I want to do my own thing and I'm doing it and my parents are supportive and they're proud. So, I don't sort of feel that pressure.
The best answer. Filmfare Award, nice soch.
I would like to thank.
Nice soch award.
Coffee with Karan season. What, six now? I think seven. I saw you on Daniel's podcast. Why didn't you come? All right, Shax, last question for you. This is from Pooja. As a writer, do you ever doubt yourself? Like, how do you know what you've written is actually good or not? And if you've ever written content for someone else, how do you write it in their voice without losing yours?
As a writer, do you think you're good? No. I think I suck all the time.
And do you ever doubt yourself?
Do I doubt myself? Oh, all the time. Literally, pretty much
all
constant
24/7. Yeah. We all doubt ourselves.
We are never happy. if I like something that I've written, 5 minutes after it goes out, I hate it.
Okay.
Like literally 5 minutes, whether it's a column or a sketch or whatever it is, like, uske baad I hate it because I can see the mistakes. There is always a voice saying, do more, ye kya kar raha, ye fuck all, you can do better than this, blah, blah. You just sort of climb down on that voice and work past it. So, the great thing is when you're in the zone and when things are going great, you feel like, fucking, I'm a king.
Yeah.
Worship my feet, motherfucker. I'm the best fucking writer there is. Which is the best part about this job. And the more constant is, fuck, ye achha nahi, achha nahi, achha nahi, which is something you battle through. So, you'll always doubt yourself. The idea is to work through that doubt, because the only solution is to just keep at it. Talent and all will not get you anywhere. Tum bas ghiso, tab jaake hota hai.
Also, sometimes I think you just have to surrender. You do your best and then you just let that material take its course. Even as an actor or as
any creator, comic, I think that's just the most common aspect. You are involved with it and then it's for the world. And your attachment to it is, you will never see it the way people see it. Like some of the shittiest things I've done, people are like, are kya funny likha.
But see, sometimes your own judgment also doesn't matter. Apne kiya hai, wo apne de diya hai, and let it take its own
doubt to sabko hota hai. I think creative people ko zyada hota hai, because a lot of it is
absolutely
it's like making a child, no? You just created a child, you release it into the world.
Abhi make karna hai child, abhi aage hum wapas child pe aage.
You, the point is, you can't control what happens to the child once the child is out there.
You don't have to always control it. That's the point.
If people could hear the voices inside our head, they'd be like, we look up to these guys, puttu underconfident sale.
Yeah, dude, like even like when we are hanging out as comedians by ourselves, when there are no cameras and stuff, like the kind of things we say, and we're like, dude, you should never get out.
Yeah, just come to accept
the public space. Yeah.
What is the next part of the question?
Have you ever written for somebody else, and how do you, not lose your voice when you write for someone else?
I mean, we have, of course, like when you, someone else meaning, okay, so there are two ways. When you're writing for a particular actor, say you're writing a sketch and I know an X actor is going to be cast in it, then you obviously write for the character you've created and you use the actor's strengths in the script. Somebody's going to physically give them that, somebody's deadpan, you give them that. If you're writing for somebody else very directly, like say if you're writing a film script for Shah Rukh or whatever, then, I mean, then the idea is to write banging jokes. And again, it's the same principle. Use whatever strengths you think he has, and write jokes accordingly. So, or if there's certain material he wants to do, etc., etc. At the heart of it, you still got to write like a tight joke. And if there is a point where you have to convince an actor to do it because he doesn't entirely get it or he's not sure, then that's what you do, right? It's part of the job. It's essentially what you've described is called writing to a brief. So,
are you ever tempted to change something when you see that the person sort of saying it is not being able to pull it off?
So sometimes they're not able to pull it off.
Yeah.
Or sometimes they do something so well that you're like, fuck, I wish I thought of that.
Right.
Fuck off.
Right.
So then that joke goes in the script and you're like, yeah, maine likha hota. So there are so many times when they've just taken your words and I don't mean just like the big actors, like the guys that we work with, etc. They add so much of their own. So again, writing, you've got to be flexible that way. And it's like writing to a brief. Yeah, if you are writing a detergent ad for a tier 3 demographic, yeah, then your voice would be different. So, wahi kaam hai, brief. Just write to a brief.
Write to a brief. It's great.
Because on Filmfare, nobody wants to hear Ashish Shakya's voice. Don't hear Shah Rukh Khan's voice. You make sure it is the funniest possible.
And he's so witty. So, you...
That's that.
All right, cool. Shriya, last question for you. Can a live medium like theater benefit from a digital medium like YouTube?
Can a live medium like theater
benefit from a digital medium like... Like, for example, like how stand-up has really exploded because of the internet.
Eventually, anything, firstly, today, digital, it gives a push.
Yeah.
I mean, as a medium, you get a push through your digital platforms anyway.
Okay.
But theater is something, I think there's... It's a very... The experience of going and watching something on stage is very different from a cine play. The point is not to watch a play at home.
At home.
You know. So, I mean, I guess you can't compare that experience at all. So, even if push as in you can promote your stuff well, but as an experience, as a whole thing, you can't get the same experience, which I think would be the same thing for your shows.
Which is what
well,
we
right?
want with stand-up as well. But unfortunately, with the nature of stand-up, is that because the gratification is so instant, people are happy to just sit back and ha, ghar pe dekh ke kaafi hai. Get those guys to get out and come watch the live show.
But I don't think they would enjoy... theater like that anyway. Like with stand-up maybe they would, but I don't think theater setup is such that they would enjoy that. Then it's like watching a web show.
No, but I think that's because the entry barrier to it culturally has been stand-up has become very masky and mainstream. Theater is still seen as elitist. Like people still think that mushkil hoga. There's a reason why.
Not
like,
anymore, man.
I don't know, Prithvi's right here.
Yeah.
But even like so many people I know will happily go for a film.
Right.
Or even a stand-up show, but there's a certain amount of inertia, unless you're already inclined to that sort
but
of
thing. But there are hardcore like theatre goers who you know who keep a tab of all the plays happening.
But to get newer audiences to come, that's the thing.
Yeah.
I think that's what he meant, just get more people in.
So I think how it helps is if the people doing the play are, I mean, if
famous.
They are, famous name, matlab, I would say if... they have a good reach on digital platforms.
Yeah.
Yeah, like for example, if they are on somebody else's podcast and they're like, hey,
yes,
she sounds
course.
Interesting,
yeah,
maybe
course,
I should go check
now,
out her
yeah,
play.
Internal Affairs Bayan, yes.
Danny has saved
theater.
He's
the savior. And today's World Theater
Day. Sanjana Kapoor, Kaun Shashi Kapoor,
I think to promote it for people. So nowadays, a lot of people, they also made little trailers talking about what their play is about. So people get a vibe of ki kya hum dekhne wale hain. So we use those techniques to sort of, you know, get our
plays.
So ye
bhi promotion hai. Ye basically Kapil Sharma hai.
Theater
ka Kapil
Sharma. World
Theater insult kyun kar raha yaar abhi?
Kiski insult ho gayi hai? Theater ki Kapil Sharma ki teri? Kiski insult ho gayi?
It's such a meta.
Sir, layered.
Layered insult. Cool. And on that note, we'll wrap up this episode. Thank you so much for being
on. Thank you.
Thanks, man.
This podcast. I hope you had fun.
Lots of fun.
Before I let you guys go, if there's anything you guys want to plug, Shriya, we've seen you in Fan recently. Is there any other projects that we can look forward to?
Yeah, I'm doing Mirzapur, which is a gangster drama, which will be on Amazon
very Prime.
Soon.
Super.
Yeah. Ali Fazal, Pankaj Tripathi, Vikrant Masi, Shweta Tripathi is there. So that's a fun thing. And I'm starting a new film soon.
Very cool. You just signed that you can't talk about it just
I can't
yet.
Talk about it.
I know what it is.
No, he doesn't.
But very cool. And theatre?
Theatre, yeah. I'm doing two plays, Internal Affairs, Bayan, with AK Various Productions. And we keep travelling with it. So, next time we perform Internal Affairs, Bayan, come. There's no need to get scared. Hum bhi bahut fun cheeze karte hain stage pe. So, please come.
Aisa accusingly mat dekho. Humne mana thodi kiya. Humne tumhara play dekha. Humne tumhara play dekha. Humne pata hai.
What about you, Ashish? Any projects that you're working on that we can catch?
Yeah, so keep watching the IB channel. There's lots more stuff coming out. We have a podcast that's about to be released soon and a lot of fun sketches lined up along the way. On the live front, Rohan and I are going to be doing like a two-man stand-up show, essentially. So it's two of us doing about 90 minutes worth of material.
Nice.
And we're going to be taking it to 6 cities starting the end of April. So I think we're doing Goa, Pune, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Guwahati and Kolkata.
Fun.
Very nice.
So it's a few weekends starting end April. Come for that. I think tickets for everything should be out soon. And eventually all of that material will hopefully eventually work its way to a special Baad Mein Kabhi. Lekin
शो टाइट है ऐसा हम लोग फनी है
फनी
खराब
है,
है, फनी है तो आ जाओ उसके लिए मजा आएगा और क्या
कैन आई ओपन विद माय जोक व्हेन आई वन ऑफ दोस
श्रेया श्रेया इज आवर ओपनिंग एक्ट एंड देन वी विल हैव अदर कॉमेडियंस आल्सो टू ओपन बट श्रेया इज ओपनिंग एक्ट
Awesome. And I'm on tour as well as I've been for a while now. Up until May, my new show Shadows is on the road. So if I'm in
which is so good, by the way.
A city near you. Yes, Shriya, thank you so much. Shriya has seen it. She liked it. You should come watch it too. Go watch her play, then watch my show and then go watch Shax and Rohan. All right. So thank you so much for tuning in. That was the episode. If you liked what you saw, let us know. If you didn't like what you saw, that's okay. Don't comment. And if you have your own experiences to share about being, growing up with too much of parental controls on the internet and stuff like that, just comment, share the episode. Audio versions of this podcast are available for download as well. Thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Daniel Fernandes. Take care. Goodbye.